Hi, my name is Ben Hodes, Senior Program Manager for Project Sienna, and in this how-to video, we're going to walk through building the Windows 8 Devices app. Let's go ahead and take a look. This app allows you to view a number of Windows 8 devices. On the left, we have a list of manufacturers. On the top, we have different device types. When I see a device that I'm interested in, I can select Save. And I can go to View Device Mix, see what happens when I purchase a number of those devices. Go ahead and add a latitude 10. And you can see the price updating. Let's jump right into Sienna and see how we built it. Now, I've already gotten started here with my app. I've added a rectangle at the top that you saw before. And I've added my data. We see here that we have two tables, actually three tables, an OEM table that has our logo information, a machines table that has all of our machines information, and a menu table that we'll use to create the menu at the top. So let's create that top menu. To do this, we're going to use a horizontal gallery. I'm going to go to Visuals. And I'm going to add a horizontal image gallery. I'm going to point to my menu table and resize and center it. Now I'm seeing that my images are being cut off a little bit, so I'm going to select the image, go to Design, and update the image position to center. Well, let's do Fit. Great. Next, we need to add a vertical image gallery on the left so that we can select our manufacturer. Let's go to Visuals, Galleries, and select a vertical image gallery. This time I'm going to point to the OEM table. Resize my gallery. And then I'm going to select the image again, go to Design, and see which image position is going to work best for me. I think Fit's going to work the best here. Let's go with that. Okay. I can actually improve this a little bit more by making my images a little bit less tall and making the template size a little bit smaller. Well, I think that looks pretty good. So let's add our gallery so we can view the machines. For this, I'm going to select Image Gallery with Text, because I want to show more information than just the picture. And on the left here, let's select our machines table. Pretty good. Instead of saying what the device type is on the bottom here, I actually want to see the amount of RAM available. So to update that, I simply select the text, the label, go to text, and select memory. Of course, at this point, we're still seeing all the machines in the table. What we want to do is filter this list down to only show the machines to the manufacturer that I've selected on the left and the device type we've selected at the top. So let's write an Excel expression to make that filter happen. I'll go to Items. I'm just going to start typing. We want to filter our machines table. We only want to see machines where their manufacturer is equal to, I'm going to hold down Alt to see all of my controls on the screen. I see Gallery 2, bang selected, bang MFR. So now the manufacturers are working and we only see Acer devices. I also want to filter and say that the device type, the device, is equal to the top gallery, so Gallery 1, bang selected, bang device type. Great. Let's test it out. When I click Dell, we see Dell machines, Dell tablets, Dell laptops, Dell all-in-ones. Another neat feature of this app is our use of conditional formatting. What I want to do is I want to have this label have a bright green background whenever the price of this computer is under $700. To set this up, we'll go to Design, We'll go to fill. And I'm going to copy this using Control C, just in case I need it later. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to use an if statement and say that if the price is less than 700, let's go with a background that's light green. Otherwise, let's go with the color that was our default. And immediately you can see that some machines are cheaper than others, and our conditional formatting lets us see that very easily. There's one more thing I need to do here on this screen, and that's add a checkbox that allows me to save the machines that I'm interested in. First, I need to make a little bit more room on my template to fit the checkbox. You can see Sienna does some resizing for us. I'm going to select the template. Now, a special note about galleries. Right now, I have nothing selected, or the screen is selected. Now I have the gallery selected, and by clicking this button, or clicking on the first item, now we have the template for the gallery selected. When I add items, if my template is selected, the item gets added to the template. You can always tell, the little cheat here is you can always tell that a template's selected because of the rest of the items in your gallery will be grayed out. So now that I have my template selected, I'm going to go and add a checkbox. And I'll call this save. Of course, we need to add the behavior that actually saves the item. So we select the checkbox, go to behavior, unchecked, and we want to collect, save this item, into a new collection, which you can think of as just a temporary table. Collection 1's fine. So when I check it, it'll save this item to collection 1. Of course, when I uncheck, I want it to remove this item from collection 1. That's all it takes. I'm going to go ahead and just populate my collection a little bit. And now let's create the second screen. On the second screen, I'll actually be able to review my devices. Go ahead, right-click or swipe from the top and hit Add Screen. I'm going to jump back to screen 1 really quick to copy our gallery. You can do that by copy-paste with Control-C. Or in the lower right-hand corner. Now, instead of navigating back to the next screen just by right-clicking and selecting screen 2, I'm actually just going to add the button that does it for us. Hit plus, select a button, move it over here, let's call it View Device Mix, and then I'm going to add a behavior. Whoops, while selecting the button, I'm going to add the behavior to unselect, then I navigate to screen 2. First thing I'm going to do on screen 2 is paste. There's my gallery. Of course, right now it's still showing the same information as before. What I wanted to show is the items in my collection. So I'm going to go to Data, Items, and I'm just going to point it to collection 1. And those were actually my machines. If I jump back to screen 1 real quick, I can copy the top rectangle here. Can also add another machine or two to our collection just to prove to ourselves that it's working. Excellent. Seems to be in working order. I'm going to paste my rectangle at the top. I'm going to go ahead and add a back button, so I can navigate between my two screens. Go to unselect, give it a navigate action back to screen 1. The last thing we need to do on this screen is actually add the ability to create a device mix. If you remember, what we're going to do is add a slider right here to allow to select the quantity of the computers that we want. And then in the upper right, we'll be able to actually view how much that would cost with a calculation in a label. First, I don't need my checkbox anymore, so I just delete it. I'm going to select my gallery, go ahead and add a slider and a label. Label I'll call quantity, and my slider we'll just drag down here. Next, we need the label in the upper right. So add a label. Call this total cost. But of course, we need to do a little bit of logic in here so that the label will actually total all of the devices that we've selected. To do this, we go to text, and I can enter my expression. What we want to do is we want to sum over, again, holding Alt to see all my controls, gallery 3 underscore 1, bang all items. We want to sum over all the items in this gallery. And what we want to do is we want to multiply the price of each item by the slider value. Do a little bit of formatting niceness. And use the text function. Define a format. Let's test it out. Looks to be in working order. I'll do a little bit of styling here on my design. Make it look a little bit nicer. Pretty happy with this. But you know what? I think we can make it even better, because I want to make the ability for me to jot some handwritten notes onto the tablets that I'm really interested in. To do this, we're going to add a pen control. So I'm going to select my gallery, drag it up to give me a little bit more space. Just rearranging. And on this, we're going to go to template size, make it a little bit, each of them a little bit more narrow. Okay, nice. And on the bottom, we're going to add our pen control. So I hit plus, add our pen. I'm not interested in seeing the controls on the bottom, so I'll just go to more, go to show controls and turn those off. And at this point, I think we have a finished app. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Jump back to the first screen, right click, go to preview mode, unselect the HPs, let's add a Surface or two, Samsung device. Sony doesn't seem to have any tablets, but they do have laptops. My pen is working exactly as expected. Fantastic. Well, I'm ready to call this a finished app. So I'm going to go ahead and drop back into Sienna, right-click, go to File, Publish, click Publish Resources locally so that all of our images come along with us. Display name, I'll just call this Win8 Devices, and publish. Publish the desktop. Go view our published package. Install the app locally. Let's check it out. Apps won't be pinned automatically in Windows 8.1, so I'm going to search for it and say, just type to search Windows 8, Win8 devices. There it is. And hey, here's my app. Awesome. I hope you enjoyed this how-to video. For more tips, tricks, and videos just like this, please find us online at aka.ms/projectsienna, and thank you very much.